invites and encourages all who are seeking a community to empower, support, and explore deeper understanding of spirituality and recovery of all kinds. We join together with our family and loved ones in our journey to enlightenment and recovery, and supporting one another spiritually without judgment or prejudice.
Good afternoon. My name is Judy G, and I'm here to welcome you to A Place of Faith. Today, we'll be speaking on the spiritual principle of possibilities. Now, if you will join me in prayer. Higher Power, we welcome you to this place and to this time. We ask that you bless us as we listen to the teachings on possibilities and learn from it. And so it is. Amen. And now I'd like to introduce you to Jody, who will play for us.
Welcome back to a better place than the one we're at. And I ain't got no kind of plan, but I've had all of this town that I can stand. And I got friends out on the coast. We can jump in the water and see what floats. We've been saving for a rainy day. Let's beat the storm and be on our way. It don't matter to me wherever we are's where I wanna be. And honey, for once in our life, let's take a chance and roll the dice. I can be your lucky penny. You can be my four-leaf clover. Starting over. This might not be an easy time. There's rivers to cross and hills to climb. And some days we might fall apart. And some nights we might feel cold and dark. When nobody wins, afraid of losing. And the hard roads are the ones worth choosing. Someday we'll look back and smile and know it was worth every mile. It don't matter to me wherever we are's where I wanna be. And honey, for once in our life, let's take a chance and roll the dice. I can be your lucky penny. You can be my four-leaf clover. Starting over. Starting over. It don't matter to me wherever we are's where I wanna be. And honey, for once in our life, let's take our chances and roll the dice. I can be your lucky penny. You can be my four-leaf clover. Starting over. Starting over. starting over. Starting over.
That was beautiful. I'm Becky R., and I'm here with the Concepts to Contemplate. I have some quotes for us today. Emily Dickinson says, "I dwell in possibility." I love that. And Roy Bennett from The Light in the Heart says, "Turn your obstacles into opportunities and your problems into possibilities." Nicholas Sparks tells us, "It's possible to go on, no matter how impossible it seems." A lot of people are still trying to figure that one out. You know, we just closed out 2020, right? And Ella Wheeler Wilcox says, "Always continue the climb. It is possible for you to do whatever you choose. If you first get to know who you are and you are willing to work with a power that is greater than ourselves to do it." I can attest to that. Stephen Hawking says, "The past, like the future, is indefinite and exists only as a spectrum of possibilities." And Harry Emerson Fosdick says, "Democracy is based upon the conviction that there are extraordinary possibilities in ordinary people." I love this one by Craig Ferguson. He's a comedian. He says, "I got sober. I stopped killing myself with alcohol. I began to think, wait a minute, if I can stop doing this, what are the possibilities? And slowly it dawned on me that it was maybe worth the risk." And the last concept today is from Charles Keering. And it says, "The Wright brothers flew right through the smoke screen of impossibility." I love that. I'm going to also share with you the principles in action, possibilities. I am a living testament to what is possible. 2.5 years ago, I had an automobile accident. I rolled an SUV on a small road in the middle of nowhere, and I crushed the top of it flat. In the meantime, I broke my neck, my back, and I was hospitalized for 6 weeks, and I was in a cast from my belly button to my neck for 6 months. I dwell in possibilities now. Everything I do, I was on so many medications, I had a traumatic brain injury, I could not remember when to take my medicines. My family had to take care of me for the first 6 months, getting me to the doctor, making sure I was there on time. And my worry at that time was, am I ever going to come out of that? And once I started to come out of it, I realized I can not only come out of it, there are more possibilities. What else can I do? You know, the doctor says, well, you'll never live the way you lived before. Watch me. I dwell in possibilities. Thank you. Jody?
I'm gonna clear out my head. I'm gonna get myself straight. I know it's never too late to make a brand new start. I'm gonna kick down the door. I'm gonna get myself in. I'm gonna fix up the yard and not fall back again. I'm gonna clean up my earth and build a heaven on the ground, not something distant or unfound, but something real to me. But something real to me. That I can be, and all that I am, I can see. All that is mine is in my hands. So to myself I come. There's somewhere else I should be. And there's someone else I can't see. There's something more I can find. It's only up to me. I'm gonna clean up my earth and build a heaven on the ground, not something distant on a cloud, but something real to me. But something real to me. I'm gonna clear out my head. I'm gonna get myself straight. I know it's never too late to make a brand new start. To make a brand new start. To make a brand new start. To make a brand new start.
To make a brand new start. Thank you, Jody. This is the 10th day of 2021. Already. Please join me in this moment of quietness. Join me in this moment of introspective. Inhale, cleansing, cleaning, energizing, loving breath. Exhale, energizing love. Possibilities abound. this is the first day of the rest of your life. It is up to me. It is up to you. But we don't have to do it alone. Chinese proverb, the longest journey begins with the first step. Take the first step to mold this life, this beautiful life that we have, to what it is you want to do with it. Possibilities are all around. Take in another breath. Reach down deeper. Deeper to within that light that we have glowing. That light that's excited and questioning and wanting to come forth. Let it burst forth. Let the love and the glow that you've been holding on to come forth, share, embrace all the possibilities that are out there for you. The past has brought us to where we are today, and we are thankful that we have traveled this path, because it brought us to the awareness where we are now. Spirit is with us at all times, guiding us, supporting us, loving us. We are not alone. We are loving children of this Spirit, and we are here to share. Embrace this thought of all the possibilities that are there. Think about what it is you want to do. And know that you can do it. Breathe in. Feel this energy, this commitment, this strength that you have to achieve any goal or idea or dream that you have. You can do it. This is the time. Take that first step. Breathe in. Feel the love within. Bring that energy, love, commitment, excitement, and joy of going after those possibilities. bring that to the here and now. Open your eyes, stretch your arms, relax, feel energized. Know this is your time. Breathe in. Be aware. Be grateful and thankful. You are who you are. And there are no limits to where you can go or what you can achieve. Hold on to that thought. Hold on to that energy and excitement. You can do it. Because you are loved. You are loving. And you are perfect. Have a wonderful week. Be blessed. Take that first step. Namaste.
Thank you, Patricia. Thank you, Jody. Let's pray. Higher power, thank you for bringing us here today. Thank you for the words, for the time, for the connection, for the love, and for all the effort that we put into bringing this and connecting to people out there. We thank you for this ability to do this and for everything that you give us. We are ever grateful. Amen. Hi, my name is Becky R. again. I wanted to share with you, I know that this year we've talked about releasing and we've talked about starting new, which was last week, the story of the Janus, the Greek god with the two faces. So today I wanted to talk to you about the spiritual principle of possibilities. I'm going to start with a story. About our place in northern Arizona. We live up what they call up the rim. We have this 40 acres in the middle of nowhere, but in order to get to it, you have to go high altitude Arizona. People don't understand that it does snow in Arizona. Okay, it does. Because they think, oh, it's all desert. It's not. The northern, especially the northern east part, you know, Flagstaff, all that stuff over there, it does snow up there. And we have a place up there. In order to get to this place, we have to go what we call is over the rim. It's a very windy road, and you're along the rim of a mountain. Okay. So, and then you go up and through this little town and through the backside, and that's where our property is, on the opposite side of the rim. So all these storm clouds that come from Phoenix come up towards this rim. And we bought this place, and it was like, thinking there's all this snow on the mountain, right? So we're like, oh, we're going to get a lot of snow. It's going to be frequent. We started noticing that there was snow, but it was almost like it would pass us by, like we were in some kind of a valley, because as the clouds got to us, there was nothing left of snow. It only snowed at our place sometimes, and usually within a day or so, it was gone. You know, we never really got big snows, and they would close the roads in town because there was so much snow, but our house, which was only 40 minutes around the corner, we weren't sure what was going on. So one of my husband's friends explained it to us. What happened is, as the clouds approached that rim, and they're full of snow, and they're full of anger, and all this, whatever they've got, and they're ready to get rid of it, they hit that rim, and everything comes out. Everything starts to fall. And as the clouds go over the rim, because they're being pushed by the weather behind it, it comes over and it starts to expand again, so there's nothing left to release. And I thought that was really interesting because we lived kind of on the other side, and it was just like, there's the releasing. They let go on the other side, and now they're expanding into possibilities, right? So the feeling of expanding and trusting and breathing on the other side, it's kind of what the possibilities feel like to me, is like getting rid of that, everything that I have to let go of in order to expand into possibilities. So possibility is defined as being able to be done within the power of capacity of someone or something, right? So being able to be done, that means having the power, the skill, the means, the opportunity to do something. Now, if you're like me, and if you're watching this, you probably are a lot like me, raised in a dysfunctional family, and many of us were, and possibilities and abilities were not at the forefront of my childhood. It was quite the opposite, okay? And that happens in a lot of our families. We, you know, the things I heard growing up would not be things that I would repeat to other children because I know, you know, the pain that it would cause. But it wasn't taught in the schools. It wasn't modeled in our homes. And it really wasn't even modeled on TV as far as I can remember, the TV that we used to watch. If you were lucky enough, I don't think we got our first TV until I was even older, you know, and I know we only had one in the house, not one in everybody's pocket like we have right now. So, and one in the room that the kids are living in. But it wasn't shown to us that there was a chance. It felt more like to me, and I don't know if it did for you, but my experience of it was more like, this is what you get. You know, so suck it up and make something of it. So without the skill being taught or modeled, what did I do? I did the opposite of what I saw. And I took that out into my life. If I felt like my parents were overbearing, I was lenient. If I felt like, you know, and I saw this a lot with the people that I knew that were working through all these problems too. Now, you might ask me right now, how did that work for me? And I'll tell you that, well, I would say it worked out fine now, but for about 30 years, it was pretty rough, you know? It wasn't easy to do. So here we are working a program, at least most of us are working a program, and some of us are white-knuckling it. Now, I don't know if everybody knows that term. It might be just an old term, and I'm an old AA-er, so white knuckling was like my dad did. My dad quit drinking at 67 years old. Just quit. Didn't go to a program, didn't go to church, didn't seek other people that were trying to quit. Just quit and white knuckled it, held on and tried to get through that, right? What if there was a softer, gentler way, an easier way for everyone around us? And what would that look like? What would that look like for you and your family? And could we see everything as a chance to grow, a possibility, right? Instead of a challenge, turning it into a possibility. This came to me at the end of the year. We were doing a bunch of the end of year stuff and the release and the renew. And I thought, what if we took the challenge and said, I just took it out of my vocabulary and said, this isn't a challenge. This is an opportunity to learn. This is an opportunity to grow, okay? So we can use the skills we have, and we can resource the rest. Now, when I say resource the rest, I'm talking about you pick up those call lists, call people. There's meetings, go to them. You know, right now, because of COVID, get online and go to them. You know, reach out to people. Those are the resources. There are resources out there for everybody, and there's a lot more building up. They're really trying to support people through all of what's going on right now. And use our combined abilities to create our possibilities. Right now, I can tell you that the Community College of San Diego is giving free online classes. You want to learn something new? Take a free class. I mean, there's resources out here for everybody. Expanding happens in nature. We can do it. We are nature. We're a part of nature, right? So expanding can be for them and as well for us. So the first time I ever stepped into a 12-step meeting, I was just a kid, I feel like. Everybody told me they loved me. You know, they kept telling me, oh, I love you, I love you. And I'm just like looking at them going, you couldn't possibly love me. I just met you. And one of the big things for me is love had cost me a lot. You know, people did things in the name of love to me or through me or whatever. So love was a very painful thing, and when somebody said they loved me and they didn't even know me, I for sure figured they wanted something from me, right? And how could a group of strangers that didn't know me, that's the trick, they didn't know me, that's how come they loved me, right? That was my little twisted mind, my little trying to get out of alcoholism and drug addiction, you know, going, oh, well, they don't really know who I am. That's why, how come they can love me? But you know what? That group of people knew me because they were me. They are. When you walk into that, who better to call me on my stuff? Who better to know who I am than the people in those walls? Than the people that are standing there going, hey, you know, I've got 5 years or I've got 5 days. And they're not white-knuckling it, and they're using their resources. And they kept telling me, come back. And it sounds so cliche. I mean, I even remember then thinking, keep coming back, keep coming back. What does that mean? And that first 90 days was really hard. I did it a couple times, but it was really hard. And to listen to, it felt like everybody was saying all these little cliche things until I started believing it. And I acted as if, and now I call it what if. Because it's possibilities, right? There are possibilities. Even after relapse, there are possibilities. We can get back into it. We can find these resources. We can pull our stuff up one step at a time. So I put together a recipe for recovery and possibilities. Okay, everybody loves to cook, right? Well, maybe not everybody, but a lot of people like to cook. So in cooking, you have the two bowls. We're going to put in the big bowl. We're going to put in courage. Now, courage is not the absence of fear. People think, oh, I can't be afraid, and that's how I have courage. That's not how it works. Courage is stepping out into it, even if you're shaking. Courage is using your voice, even if it shakes. And I didn't learn that till I was in my late 20s, because I had really cut myself off from my voice, that I could talk even if I squeaked when I did, right? So it is the action. Despite of the fear, it's taking that first step. It's going to that first meeting. It's going to that first meeting over again after you've had a bunch of sobriety. And I know a lot of people that have years of sobriety that went back out again and needed to come back to their spirituality, needed to come back to their possibilities inside those rooms, and they had to come back through it. So we're going to add in some trust, and that's trusting AA. That's trusting those people that tell you, I love you. Even though you don't know how they love you, that's trusting them, right? We're going to put in some humility and some accountability, mix it in there, because we have to admit where we went wrong. We have to admit our wrongs to ourselves and to someone else, because the secrets are what keep us where we are, and we don't want any more secrets. We're going to throw in a little bit of desperation, because some of us got there. You know, it was like, this is it or not. You know, things had to change. They had to be different. I could not end up the way that I was headed on the path that I was headed on. And a dash or two of rock bottom. Some people have a pound or two of rock bottom. But for some people, they got lucky and they had a dash or two of the rock bottom. We're going to leave that all in the big bowl. Now, the amount of it is going to depend differently on everybody. That's why I didn't say a quarter cup or a half a cup. So it depends on what's going on in your life. But if you can mix that all in there, and then we'll take the smaller bowl, and we're going to put in some of the nesses. Okay, the N-E-S-S-E-S, the nesses. Things like willingness. We have to be willing. We have to remember that we can't do everything ourselves. Even if we were Superman, we couldn't do it all ourselves. Okay? Superman had, of course, friends, right? Openness. Can we be open to the possibility that these people love us, that this group of people right here doing this love you enough to give you this talk and to bring you into their fold and give you more resources, okay? Kindness. We got to help other people. We got to share our story. We got to sit and listen and understand, and even if we don't agree with everything they're going through, that's their stuff, and they have the right to have it just as much as we have the right to have ours. And gratefulness, knowing that I'm not alone. I'm never alone, even if I'm in a room alone. And I didn't find that out until I was 36. I really didn't know that I wasn't alone. We're going to add in a dash of service in the bowl, of course, because you got to get out. We got to mix all these up together, okay? So we can add those two bowls together, and if we're lucky, some of us are, we can add in the options of we have some family, maybe some family that's been through this, this healing. Some people have to let go of their family and their friends. We can add in some friends, some nature maybe. Maybe we feel at home in nature, meditation, all these other little things, church, people, spirituality, okay? We need to mix it up all together with some frequency, some time, some stability, some support and sponsorship. Not only just getting a sponsor, but when you're ready, being a sponsor. Because I almost learned more from being a sponsor than I do when I am sponsored. It is really a powerful place to be, to ask your sponsor about a sponsee you're working with and work through things with your sponsees. We're going to bake it all up to make it stick, and we have what we want, a beautiful birthday cake, right? In sobriety. So what if the world was for you or me? What if every step we took, we knew there were possibilities in it, that we could succeed in it? And if it wasn't a success in the way we thought it was a lesson, which is a success in a different form. We found out what we didn't want, right? What if we could live from there? What if we could breathe that in, just living from possibilities, like that beautiful meditation. Let's live from the possibilities, the place where we are. Everything is possible. We're expanding, we're trusting, we're breathing freely. We're going with the flow, and we can release and let go of the snow on the other side. Just let it go. I have an affirmation. It says, everything I encounter is possible, and the world is on my side. The world is on my side. I know I'm making progress, and I use the promises as my measuring stick. And I know that it's something that's occasionally read inside the meetings. I'd like to take this opportunity, though, to read them to you and have you just listen to the words and see how they're sticking to you. Maybe this is frosting on the cake. We'll see, okay? So I have to stop, and I have to reread them occasionally just to remember. It's my looking back. It's my yardstick. How far have I come? These are the ones from AA. Everything's a little different. So number one is, if we are painstaking about this phase of our development, we will be amazed. Now, the painstaking part really scared me at first, but it was a lot more pain for me to stay where I was than it was for me to grow to who I needed to be. And number two, we are going to know a new freedom and a new happiness. New doesn't even cover it, I feel like. A new freedom and a new happiness of being not caught in that pain anymore is amazing. Number three, we will not regret the past nor wish to shut the door on it. That was a hard one for me, because there were things that I did regret. And now I understand it wasn't really a regret. I really shouldn't have done those things. I can't go back and change that I did. And I made my amends, and I can hold them as lessons. They were lessons that I learned from, and other people learned too. Number four, we will comprehend the word serenity, and we will know peace. Know it. And that's different than just, oh yeah, there's peace out there, here, let me sit and meditate. When you can feel it through your body, when you know that you're peaceful in it, it's amazing to look at that yardstick and see that how little peace there was to how much peace there is. Number five, no matter how far down the scale we have gone, we will see how our experience can benefit others in their possibilities. No matter where we landed, we are as much a tool of the higher power as our sponsor is to us, and as all of these people that testify are to us. We are that much of a tool. We are that much of a possibility for someone else, because we all share these stories. Number six, that feeling of usefulness, un, uselessness and self-pity will disappear. And that's how. Because we realize that our stories in our life have some meaning, and where we're getting to makes a difference. Number 7, we will lose interest in selfish things and gain interest in our fellows. That's a big one. That is a fun one. When we start finding all these, I mean, I've been to some really cool, I don't think they do them anymore, but some really great like New Year's Eve parties for AA and NA. And I can tell you, these people can rock. You know, if you want to go to a party, oh, recovering alcoholics, recovering NA, we had the kids there, we were dancing, we were having a great time because we were all on the same level. We were all there together. And 8, self-seeking will slip away. We learn that it's the community, right? And 9, our whole attitude and outlook upon life will change. That is a big one. Because when I go back and look back and I revisit all those years ago, I remember all the pain and hurt, and I look at my life now and it's just like, wow, what a difference. What a, you know, and I imagine 20, 30 years from now, what I'll be looking back on now. So 10, fear of people and of economic insecurity will leave us. I was really afraid of people because people, to me, equaled pain. I thought that's where my pain was coming from. And, you know, we live and we learn, right? But I was very afraid of people. 11, we will intuitively know how to handle situations which used to baffle us. This is a fun one. Because someone will come up and say, ask you a question or something, and you'll just answer it. And they're like, was that me? Did I say that? I didn't know that was even in me. Because before I would have went, well, I'm not really sure. Let me think. Let's go ask so-and-so, you know. And 12, we will suddenly realize that God is doing for us what we could not do for ourselves. Every single time I say that one, I cry. Because God all along was doing things for me. And once I started acting in knowing that, and I knew that I was never alone, that God was with me, my whole life changed. And it goes on to say that are these extravagant promises? We think not. I know not. They're not extravagant promises. They are fulfilled among us sometimes quickly, sometimes slowly, and they will always materialize if we work for them. Okay? So what if just for today, because that's all we have, we accept that the world has got our back and that we have ahead of us infinite possibilities? Anything is possible, folks. What could you or I do with a life lived where everything is possible? So that affirmation one more time, in case you want to write it down, is everything I encounter is a possibility. And the world is on my side. I will leave you with this quote from Thomas Merton. You do not need to know precisely what is happening or exactly where it is all going. What you need is to recognize the possibilities and the challenges offered by the present moment and to embrace them with courage, faith, and hope. Now, I want to say thank you for baking me my birthday cake. Today, as you're watching this, I'm 23 years sober. And I thank you for joining me in this moment. Let's pray. Father, Mother, God, we thank you. We thank you for our time together. We thank you for our fellowship and for the connection to it and for the words of wisdom that come from you to serve it. And we appreciate all the time and effort it takes to put it together. We are grateful for everything that you give us. Amen.
Thank you, Becky. Possibilities, opportunities to be of service. The Salvation Army in El Cajon needs food donations. Please contact them. San Diego Blood Bank needs blood. Please contact them. be of service. We want to work with your organization and bring a place of faith to you. Contact us. Our email is aplaceoffaith@zohomail.com. Let us help you. Thank you for your donations, both monetary and prayer. The monetary ones help us bring this service to you. You can send your donations to Unity Church of El Cajon, 311 Highland Avenue, El Cajon, California, 92020. Or you can go on the website, unityofelcajon.org, hit the donate button, enter your information, and please remember to put on in the memo that this is for a place of faith. Or you can contact Unity Church of El Cajon at 619-579-9586 and give us your credit card information. Again, make sure that you mention this is for a place of faith. At this moment, we will ask Jody to bring our song and service to an end.
A lot of us grew up believing at any moment we could lose it all. At the drop of a hat, God might turn his back and move on. A lot of us feel like we blew it, thinking that we're just too far gone. But I want you to know there's still a hope for you now. No matter what you've done, you can't erase his love. Nothing can change it. You're not separated, no matter what. It's never been a better time to get honest. There's never been a better time to get clean. So come as you are, run to the light and be free. Be free, no matter what you've done. You can't erase his love. Nothing can change it. You're not separated. No matter where you run, he's always holding on. You're still a daughter, you're still a son, no matter what. You're still a daughter, you're still a son, no matter what.
Thank you, Jody. That was beautiful. Thank you to all of you for joining us today and for listening to what we have to say about possibilities. There is possibilities for everyone and every way. And join me in a closing prayer. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there's despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to understand as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. And so it is. Amen.
Here at A Place of Faith, we want you to know that you're not alone. We know how challenging these times are. We want you to know we're all in this together, doing the best that we can, where we are, with what we have. Reaching out and asking for assistance isn't always easy. It takes courage and strength. We understand this struggle as well. Below you will find a list of local resources that are here to assist those in need. If you have an emergency, please dial 911. Your health in mind, body, and spirit are very important to us. Blessings.